resolved. Negroes should be admitted.
I can't hear you.
Resolved. Negroes should be admitted to state universities. My partner and I will prove that blocking a Negro's admission to a state university is not only wrong, it is absurd. The Negro people are not just a color in the American fabric. They are the thread that holds it all together. Consider the legal and historical record. May 13, 1865, Sergeant Crocker, a Negro, is the last soldier to die in the Civil War. 1918, the first U.S. soldiers decorated for bravery in France are Negroes, Henry Johnson and Needham Roberts. 1920, the New York Times announces that the N in Negro would hereafter be capitalized.
To force upon the South what they are not ready for would result in nothing but more racial hatred. Dr. W.E.B. Du Bois, he's perhaps the most eminent Negro scholar in America. He comments, "It's a silly waste of money, time, and temper to try and compel a powerful majority to do what they are determined not to do."
My opponent so conveniently chose to ignore the fact that W.E.B. Du Bois is the first Negro to receive a Ph.D. from a white college
called Harvard. Dr. Du Bois, he adds, "It is impossible, impossible for a Negro to receive a proper education at a white college."
The most eminent Negro scholar in America is the product of an Ivy League education. You see, Du Bois knows all too well the white man's resistance to change. But that's no reason to keep a black man out of any college. If someone didn't force upon the South something it wasn't ready for, I'd still be in chains and Miss Book here be running for my own massa.
I do admit it. It is true. Far too many whites are afflicted with the disease of racial hatred. And because of racism, it would be impossible for a Negro to be happy at a Southern white college today. And if someone is unhappy, it is impossible to see how they could receive a proper education. Yes, a time will come when Negroes and whites will walk on the same campus and we will share the same classrooms. But sadly, that day is not today.
As long as schools are segregated, Negroes will receive an education that is both separate and unequal. By Oklahoma's own reckoning, the state is currently spending 5 times more for the education of a white child than it is spending to educate a colored child. That means better textbooks for that child than for that child. Oh, I say that's a shame, but my opponent says today is not the day for whites and coloreds to go to the same college, to share the same campus, to walk in the same classroom. Well, would you kindly tell me when is that day gonna come? Is it gonna come tomorrow? Is it gonna come next week? In 100 years? Never? No, the time for justice, the time for freedom, and the time for equality is always right now.